Hey everybody, welcome back to Let's Play The Binding of Isaac. Gonna do exactly the same thing we did last time. We're gonna get some good old quality Isaac play in, and there's a lot of money on this room. But we don't want to necessarily access it yet. Would love to come across some more bombs first. And we're on Basement XL. Wow, a lot of stuff has happened right off the get-go here. So we're gonna have two treasure rooms, both of which will require a key. And I have neither of the two keys required to access either of them right now, so we're in kind of a rough spot. But hopefully, you know, that will all sort itself out. If we don't get any keys on this floor, I'll probably just restart this run, because I really have no interest in doing a run, you know, where maybe we go to, like, the Catacombs XL next. And we don't have any treasure with which to get it there, then we don't get any keys, and it's just a nasty cycle of keylessness. You know what they say, you know, the keyless get keylesser. I was trying there. That was like the poor get poorer. Didn't really work out so hot. I'm very tempted to use this bomb to pop open that treasure chest, but it worries me because we could use this bomb to accomplish some great things. We'll check in here for some money. There's 1 cent. If we could get... I want to get to the point... Wow, we got 2 cents out of that. Where I could use, like... There's 7 cents in two of those. So I could use a... get to, like, 7 cents, use a bomb, pick up another 7 cents, and then potentially use that at the shop. That's what I'm thinking right now. So I'm gonna save, you know, my bomb use until I know whether I can actually make that happen or if I have to do something else. That was pretty bad damage, which might impinge on my ability to actually... key, excellent. Might impinge on my ability to get a deal with the devil on this floor. But we're gonna hope that that's not gonna be an enormous problem. Running into a lot of this, like, 6 poop levels, which is A-okay with me. We're getting close to that 7th... scent, but remember that I would need a key as well. We're gonna totally skip over chocolate milk. Fuck you, chocolate milk. I will take blood of the martyr instead for extra damage up. And we're already shooting bloody tears. That is actually awesome. I like that a whole hell of a lot. If we don't get to 7 cents, maybe we'll use this bomb to open up that chest. Maybe we'll get another key as a result of that. Who knows? We're also gonna look out. I mean, our most important thing right now is just getting another key. So otherwise, I mean, we can't go to the shop without another key. We can't go to the treasure room without another key. So, that is obviously our principal problem. I'm so happy to have gotten a damage upgrade on the first floor and now feel like I stand a fucking chance against some of these enemies. Like, we actually did manage to win the last run. I apologize if you haven't seen it yet. What are you doing? You should watch these in order, you dangus. Bad gas, that's not so good. But we'd copped out. We went to Shoal instead of going to the cathedral. I would love, like, a good cathedral chest run, but I need this damage in order to make it happen. 1 cent? Well, we got tons of keys now. That's a good start. And we've got maximum fire rate, which I will absolutely take. Yeah, that is actually really solid here for the first floor. Crazy DPS. Beats our DPS on the last run, that's for sure. So, what we're gonna do here while we have a D6 charge is go fight this boss. We'll use our D6 if necessary. And then we will, you know, take it from there. Let's just put it that way. So we're gonna start with regular version of Monstro here. This should be very easy, even though I took some pretty dumb damage just standing in the way of the shots. Like I've said 100 times, sometimes when I'm fighting Monstro and he does this attack, I find it very difficult to tell where those shots are gonna land. Like, I have no perspective on like whether they're high up in the air or like close to the ground, if they arc or if they travel straight, who knows. I'll get back to you in a second, pageant boy. Instead, we'll deal with little Steven. This is better, because I know whatever item we get here is going to be A-okay. And I'm thinking, like, maybe pageant boy is going to be good, because then I can use my bomb to open that chest, and I can just use pageant boy to get that money that is necessary for me to go to the shop. Who knows? That was bad. Please just drop some hearts. Like, why are the bosses not dropping hearts? It's been a good run so far. I don't want to lose it in the stupidest way possible by just never getting red heart drops. Well, of course, taking stupid damage in the interim. I'm gonna guess that we're not gonna get a deal with the devil here. And I guess correctly. We'll take little Steven. Well, we don't need to use our D6 for anything else except the shop. Let's do it. Now, hopefully we can find 1 more cent or 2 more cents. Otherwise, this seems like kind of a waste. I could have re-rolled Pageant Boy and possibly picked up something better. Like, for example, you know, a health upgrade, which is something I kind of desperately need right now, because we've gotten apparently 0 red heart drops. Could play Judgment for a while, but I don't know if that's the best thing. What I could do, use that bomb, get 7 cents, go to the shop. Whether I buy something or not, I can then give the balance of that money to Judgment. But let's, you know, examine all of our possibilities here before we move on too much. Really pleased with the items that we got on the first floor, with the exception of Pageant Boy. But hey, more bombs, Okay. To a certain extent, problem solved. Probably should have waited on that one. But hey, picked up 5 cents out of that anyway. I'm gonna hold on to these bombs for a second. Okay, what I'm thinking now, that was a nice spirit heart drop, is go to the shop. Buy something if there's something good. If there's not anything good, that's fine too. We'll just come back here and give some money to Judgment if we need a top up to 15 cents. Fuck. Okay, we need a top up to 15 cents. We'll just use a bomb and pick up 7 cents when we leave. So I passed up on... Wow. Wow. You know what? Fuck it. I don't want Book of Revelations. Let's reroll it. Magnet. Okay, that's actually really awesome for us. As we move into this next room here, because I should be able to pick up, you know, like 20 cents. Oh, come to me, my pretties. Without actually doing anything at all, really. And now that I've done this, I think it's a smart idea for us to go to the shop and pick up the map, now that I have this much money. Probably pick up the spirit heart as well. And then we'll be able to find the secret room, and the secret room might give us even more money, or another item, who knows. In any case, that was a hell of a good first floor for us. Started out not necessarily looking so hot. Ended up looking hot as fuck. We're gonna come down here to the right, and through there we should be able to get a little bit more money. Was it 1 cent? I don't even walk out of bed for 1 cent. And I could open that chest, but I'm not gonna. So what do we pick up there? Odd mushroom for increased rate of fire. The martyr, or blood of the martyr, for much increased damage. Magnet. Briefly Book of Revelations, as well as the map. And 19 cents, so that was really more than I could have possibly expected from the basement part 1 and 2 combined. Especially since I started that with kind of a negative attitude, like, oh, we're gonna have to restart this run. So we have bad gas. I mean, we got the pill in the game as well, but I actually just have bad gas. I just wanted to point that out there. It's been something that has really affected me my entire life, and I think it's just time that I, you know, cleared the air. Cleared the air. Oh, I crack myself up sometimes. So, we're just gonna keep going here. Oh, also, I totally forgot that we lost a spirit heart there. That was a waste. Totally forgot that we got little Steven as well, so he's gonna help us do a little extra damage. Moreover, he's gonna be like a fly killer for us. When the flies get in our face. We're gonna pick up the compass. Map plus compass. Age-old combination. We're gonna spend all our money in here. Picked up a key and a spirit heart as well. Map compass is a great combination, the likes of which the world has seen only a few thousand times before. And we're gonna fight the boss right away, because we're already here, and we already have our D6 ready. So, why the hell not, right? Got bad gas, too, that I can use against Pestilence. Yes, that's exactly what I wanted. I wanted to get Pestilence to shoot at the Tinted Rock that was down there. So that will give us another 2 Spirit Hearts. And he will die very quickly. And he's gonna give us a cube of meat. I mean, that sucks. But it's possible. You never know that maybe we will get a deal with the devil, and there'll be like a one hard mom's knife or something. It happens from time to time. So we'll pick this up. I don't think either of those are... Oh, I should have re-rolled them. What was I thinking? But that's fine. So I didn't pick up the pact, and I didn't pick up Luckfoot. Neither of them are really that appealing to me. That's alright. You know? You can't be everything for everyone, Satan. Unless you give, like, only Brimstone mom's knife. Which would be just silly at that point. It's called the Brimstone of Isaac. Okay, we got lots of health. Unfortunately, I don't really want to go to the self-sacrifice rooms because it would be, you know, a waste of a spirit heart. Or waste of many spirit hearts, potentially. More money, more bombs! The bombs were kind of a sore spot for me until very recently. I actually have to confess that I thought that was my own bullet that was coming for me. I was like, hur, let's just look at that more closely by sticking my head, like, right in front of it. Oh well. Lost a little bit of damage, but we've been amassing a ton of spirit hearts lately, and I really can't complain about the damage that we are doing. Kinda sucks that we only picked up cube of meat. However, you know, cube of meat, it has the potential to become something much greater. Okay, so we'll take him out, and there we go, 1 extra cent for our troubles. We don't have the Steam sale, I have to remember, I bought compass map, okay. Which is a great combination, of course, especially as we move forward into the chest and the womb. That will help us out a good deal. Now, we need some extra health in order to get to the chest in the womb, so hopefully we come across lard or something in here. Homing bombs, which we will reroll to become laser. That's shitty. So, I mean, I guess in hindsight, we probably should have just gone with the homing bombs, but alas, you know, you can't really know that until it's too late. I was hoping for more of a damage or health increaser. And a ton more money, so we're gonna be able to go to the shop on the next floor to inevitably fight greed. But in any case, so far so good. Maybe we'll get lucky and there'll be another deal with the devil in here. Oh, we can't reroll it anyway. And we don't want the item, so it's all good. Not as good of a floor as the last one, but hey, beggars can't be choosers. We're still definitely way stronger than we need to be by this point in the game. And we have an arcade, which means that's key. It opens doors. I don't like that's key. What I'm gonna try to do, actually, obviously we're gonna go to this boss trap room, but I want to get my D6 ready first. So I'll need to go to a couple more rooms in order to make that happen. And actually many more rooms in order to make that happen. So let's just, you know, do exactly that and make that happen. I could fight the mini-boss. I should fight the mini-boss. And I'll fight the mini-boss on the room, or on the charge of the D6. To maximize my chances there, I think. So we'll go back, we'll fight the mini-boss, no matter who it is. This means that our shop does not have greed in it, which is great. Instead, we're gonna fight Wrath. Okay, so I can always reroll Wrath's item if it's not very good. I have a feeling it's gonna be homing bombs, just because the game has a tendency to do that. And basically say, hey, you didn't want homing bombs before? How about now, motherfucker? Reroll this shit. Well, we don't have to worry about that. Instead, we just pick up 4 bombs. D6 is ready, so we will take ourselves down as low as we can go here. Well, not as low as we can go. Fairly close, though. Alright, so we'll get that money. And now we will go to our boss trap room. We got tiers up. Range up, okay. I'm gonna try to earn another reroll. I realize I'm minimizing my chances to be able to do that. I don't want the heart. Minimizing my chances of being able to reroll, you know, the boss room and the item room. That's okay. I need to get a health upgrade, and this is one of my best chances of getting that health upgrade, I think. So let's just avoid that heart again. We'll have to avoid that at least one more time. Wow, this is kind of a clusterfuck right now. Get out of my face. Okay, perfect. More money. One more charge on this bad boy. And then we might as well go check this stuff out and, like, examine our potential options. Like, do we really want to use a D6 on a range upgrade when there's, like, something absolutely awful in the item room? Probably. I mean, let's see what the shop's got for us first. Yeah, you know what? We might as well buy the Steam sale. I mean, when the Steam sale's on half price, that's kind of a message, isn't it? And then we'll go check out what we got in here. Lard, I wanted this. So we'll take that, and we'll have to go back to the blood bank. Our speed's gone a little bit lower, but that should be fine. For the extra 2 hearts, I think that is fair compensation. So we'll go back to our blood bank here. We're gonna be back to 15 cents again. What can I say? We've had a very lucky run so far with respect to cash. I was really hoping for the blood bag, of course. Oh well. And then we'll reroll this again, and we'll get one chance to reroll our boss item as well. There we go, another HP upgrade. Exactly what I wanted. That turned out perfectly. So I used bad gas on Monstro, been holding on to that for quite a long time now. This run's gone very well so far. It hasn't been overpowered, but we've gotten very good items. I mean, I think we've maximized our chances of... Come on. I hate when that boss just spawns, like, right in your fucking face. You're like, what do you want me to do? What can I do? And this was very easy, even though we did take, you know, half a spirit heart of damage. Not the end of the world. Especially when we pick up a beautiful red heart at the end. Then we'll just make our way to the boss, hoping for... I would even welcome a speed upgrade right now. It hurts me to not reroll speed upgrades, because they're not that good. You know, they don't have as much of an impact on your success as, like, a damage upgrade or anything like that. But I would welcome a speed upgrade at this point. Just to nullify the lard downgrade I got. I mean, I am taking a decent amount of damage, it's just the... There's been a lot of heart drops to compensate for it. So I don't have to sweat my overall health too much. So we're almost back to full health. We can get ready to fight the boss here. We might have one more room. Which we might as well go to, you know. Bombs, keys, you never know. All of that stuff would be handy. Keys more than bombs, I suppose, at this point. With only one more conga line. If I had known that it was a conga line, probably wouldn't have gone in. But alas... That is water under the bridge now, as we go to fight Peep. Trying to find a segue into, like, water under the bridge. Oh, maybe someone peed in the water under the bridge. Haha, Peep. I tried, what can I say? So, we're almost to the halfway point of the Peep fight here. What do I want? HP, damage, speed, any of those, I will probably not reroll. But anything else, I think, is fair game for a shuffling. Oh man, we got an angel room. I was just gonna say, it's been a while since I've had a deal with the angel. And that's Guardian Angel. We'll reroll that and pick up the relic. Nice reroll. Guardian Angel isn't so bad, and in fact, can oftentimes come very much in handy when you go to the, you know, the Isaac and Blue Baby fights, because it increases your defensive abilities. Oh man, there's gonna be an open shop on this floor too. Like, no greed in the shop, that's awesome. Yeah, it increases, like, the amount of shots that get blocked on those Isaac and Blue Baby fights. But, Relic, of course, way better, because we're gonna get just a shit ton of Spirit Arts. And we're gonna be able to buy something else from the shop here as well. I'm a lucky man. And I have enough keys to actually make this happen. I almost made it out of that. And enough bombs to actually access this red chest as well. And you never know what this could contain. Possibly deal with the devil item. Although that's rare. Ah, troll bomb. That is substantially more common. Alright, so we're gonna focus, now that we know, like, the layout of this entire level, just gonna focus on maximizing our D6 potentials. We're gonna plan this out accordingly. So, like, I'm making my way over to the item room and shop first. If I don't use a reroll there, then we can go to the boss and I can use a reroll there. And we'll see, I'm leaving as much open space as possible so that I can reroll as many times as possible if we run across an item that I really do not like. So let's start with the shop here. Candle! Okay, well, we're gonna buy the candle. I'm gonna spoil that for you. We're just gonna see if we want to reroll anything. We definitely want to reroll this. For Polyphemus, that is really good. Oh man, that is good. And then we're gonna get ready to reroll the boss item, if necessary, as well. So I'm gonna try to build up, you know, some D6 charges now to allow me to do that. But I'm so happy to get Polyphemus in combination with this run. Probably shouldn't have gone to that room. Should have just bum rushed the raid for the boss. But oh well, not a problem. Polyphemus, of course, benefits us in two ways. It makes our shots super powerful and super big, so we're not gonna miss as much, but also makes our shots travel through enemies if they do more damage than the enemy has HP remaining. So this can help us out in situations like this, as you saw right there. So we don't need really, oh my god, there's a dime here. This has been an unbelievably lucky run. We don't really need to examine the rest of this floor unless I'm just trying to build up even more D6 charges. Which might be necessary if we get a shitty item from the boss, but if we run into something that drops, like, a predetermined item, so be it. And then we'll just go, we'll take the candle and get the fuck out of here, because that is going to allow us to do, like, so much damage that it's crazy. But if this is an HP damage upgrade, even a tears upgrade at this point I would probably take, because it would increase our rate of fire, I think. That's bad damage on my part. Losing spirit hearts like crazy, can't afford to do that now, even though I have this crazy damage. Loki is dead. I'm trapped! Oh, and that was not good either. But we got another deal with the devil. Should have rerolled that, but, or deal with the angel, I should say. That's all stats up. I can't in good conscience reroll that, even if I am trying to get sacred tears. So let's see what we got here. You never know. Range down. Not a good start. Friends till the end is okay. We got bad gas, of course, and health up. That's good. Alright, so we're gonna pick up this candle. We are doing some crazy damage here. We're gonna buy the candle, we might buy some other stuff, who knows. Thank God for that all stats upgrade, compensates a little bit for that range down anyway. Got the candle, we'll buy this, cause why the heck not? And now, the other thing, like, we passed up on Guardian Angel earlier and I said, well, we might regret that when we come to the Isaac fight. Well, probably not anymore, because we have the candle, which actually absorbs those shots from Isaac and Blue Baby, and might make it possible for us to succeed here. Should probably go explore more rooms because we have the relic and that will give us more spirit hearts overall. However, you know, things are going pretty well so far. So I'm just gonna try to go to the shop here. Try to create, like, the greatest shop of all time, or the greatest run of shops of all time, where somehow every single one has not contained greed and also contained good items. This is like 4 items I bought from the shop on this run alone. Maybe only 3, but still. I used the candle a couple times there, I guess. What's this pill? I thought we had this pill. Bombs are key. You know. I guess we'll go to the secret room. and pick up tons more money, which we will hopefully get to spend in the shop, although I am a little bit skeptical. Kind of thinking we are going to get screwed when it comes to the shop. But I mean, it's not really screwed because we did really well on our last four or five shops. Would love to be able to go to the boss trap room, but no arcade on this floor means this is probably not in the cards for us. But hey, there's another nickel. For all the money we've spent, to still have money is absurd. Well, we'll buy a key. I mean, we probably don't need 10 keys. In fact, we probably need bombs more than anything else. Oh well. Let's move down to the item room here. There is an arcade. Oh, but I don't want to do all that backtracking just to get to the boss room. It's all good. We're going to be fine for a little while anyway. If we lose and that ends up being the problem, we'll be so far away from that decision that it won't feel like it's the problem anymore. So that's what's keeping me going right now. That's my excuse. Can't get to that tarot card, sadly. That was a pretty awful way to take damage. I don't know what I was assuming there. I was just like, it won't hit me. Look at me. He won't hit me. He hit me. So we'll focus item room and then just straight into the boss, I guess. We don't really have much keeping us elsewhere. I kind of hate this room. We're gonna have to do a lot of dodging. And a lot of aiming, apparently, because I am the worst. Oh god, that was close. So, come on. Come to daddy. One more shot will do it. Really thought that candle would do it. I haven't made good use of the candle yet. Speaking of which, great, like unbelievably great spacebar items so far. D6, Book of Revelations showed up. I got one spirit art out of that. But yeah, still like crazy good spacebar items. Can't complain about those at all. Book of Sin, not really a great spacebar item. But I'll take the spirit art anyway. That was pretty lucky. And we will use a key to access this chest. I mean, we have all these keys, so we might as well. Could play the blood bank a few times as well. I was gonna say that was close, but in actuality, it was so close I got hit. So one more on that dude, one more scent, which will almost certainly never come in handy. I kind of hate this room as well, to be honest with you. You'd think I would eventually adjust to these. Considering, you know, Depths Part 2, I've been playing this floor for like almost a year now. Nope, still a pain in the ass. Okay, so we got a spirit heart out of that guy. That wasn't from the relic either, so we stood a chance to get another one. Sadly, no, but we'll probably pick up another one before this boss fight anyway. Oh, that was stupid. Polyphemus sometimes, you know, with great power comes great responsibility. Gotta make sure we're not around those dudes when they explode. So there was our relic proccing again. Chubb kinda doesn't stand a chance here. As you saw, and now we will fight Mom. The fast version of Mom that will also die very quickly. The only problem with this version and my current set of items is that the candle is never gonna hit for too long, but we're doing so much damage per shot that it doesn't really matter. Well, that's stupid damage. Oh well. Speaking of which, no trinkets yet. We're gonna get the Polaroid here, but I've been like bereft of trinkets lately. Definitely take the HP upgrade, that's gonna be nice. Oh, fuck! What can you do but laugh at this point, right? You know, at least we're not going for Platinum God. I'll just head straight down to Shoal, I guess, and kick Satan's ass. Oh, that is disappointing, though. I don't know what I was thinking. I was just like, yeah, get the HP upgrade, then the go! Oh, well. Oh, well. This is Isaac for fun, not Isaac, you know, for competitive value. So it turns out all this candle talk is for naught. I have absolutely no need for this candle to absorb bullets. Still does a fuck ton of damage. I'm okay with that. And what would, you know, a Binding of Isaac video from Northern Lion be without some sort of colossal mistake? I'm picturing like the two guys from the Muppet Show on their balcony right now, like the peanut gallery. They're like, entertaining, that's what it would be. Fuck you guys. You're crotchety. Anyway, I'm done talking to these imaginary people. So we're just gonna keep on keeping on versus Gemini here. Don't foresee too many problems coming our way. Ooh. And we get a spirit heart just randomly. And maybe another one from the relic. Maybe. Nope, we get a penny. Oh well. Skolex! Blast Assist. Not substantially harder with our current, you know, lineup of items. Let's fire some candle shots in here, which should be enough to basically guarantee a split. Oh, close. Blast Assist is actually not that easy. Try not to rag on the dude, you know, he's had a hard life. Just chilling down here, and then all of a sudden this asshole, new guy in town, comes in. Hey, I'm gonna murder you. I never said he had a way with words. Another deal with the angel! How is this possible? Scapular gives us a spirit heart when we have like half of a red heart left or something. Not really that good. If I had D6, I probably would have rerolled that for sure. Oh well. Can't really complain too much. Pretty sure that we are just gonna basically tear ass for the rest of our time here. I don't really foresee anything stopping us, to be honest with you, beyond my own stupidity. I guess I can waste bombs now, because we're coming dangerously close to the end of the game. What was that, like 30 cents inside of that? Well, that was stupid. Fire the candle! I guess you don't have to worry if you fire the candle at those dudes. I was worried, like, when I hit down, it was going to make them shoot at me. But that doesn't matter, because the candle actually absorbs those shots anyway. Smart thinking, right? Not at the time, but, you know, afterwards. So, we got three of these assholes left. One of these assholes left, plus guts. And we got Mom's Heart. This is going to be, I'm seriously like the luckiest person on Earth this run. Except for the fact that I abandoned the Polaroid. But maybe we'll actually pick it up as a drop somewhere. I mean, it's unlikely. Could happen, though. Just keep hanging out with the candle here. Should be real easy. Did I pick up four bombs in that that one chest? That was like the most loaded regular chest I've ever seen. Okay, so we got the candle to recharge here. And just take out three of the zombies. Piercing shots would be really good with this. But I'm not gonna worry about it too much, considering the way that things are going right now. We're gonna continue with bombs now. A couple more candle shots should be able to get the job done here. And there we go. So we might as well go up to the cathedral. Who knows, maybe we'll get the Polaroid drop while we're up there. I'm not gonna sweat it though. I'm probably just gonna bum rush Isaac here. And if we beat Isaac, I will consider this a success. Why not use bad gas on these guys? Well, I can think of one reason. That reason, of course, being that we could use it on the final boss, potentially make him way easier. Remember when we thought Isaac was the final boss of Isaac? Those were the days. So one dude left. Sorry, one asshole. That was incredibly stupid damage. Can't believe this dude isn't dead yet, though. There we go, fucking finally. It's a long trip to get to Isaac here. Oh, that's not good. But if we only lose one heart per room, I think we're still gonna make it here. This is when flying would be awesome. Sadly, no such luck. Ah, nice bounce. Off the rebound. There we go. We'll just get the fuck out of here. And then do the same thing over again, this time actually taking damage. Sadly. Tried to dodge there. I did my part. Okay, we're out of here. Oh, no! I should have just stayed here. Whatever, we're gonna get back to where we were. Yes, we'll pop this open for the thumbtack. Sure, why not? I mean, not really much else holding us here at this point, because I skipped over that trinket. That shall remain nameless. I guess I deserve that for complaining about not getting the Polaroid so many times. I deserved one of me being like... Oh man, if that had happened on like one of the runs where I was trying to beat the game. Seriously, that would have been bad. Some of my shots, I guess they get random tier effects. Like, some of my shots are huge. Well, we're gonna try this. I think we're gonna succeed, to be honest with you. I'm just gonna try to save my candle shots. Yeah, for situations where he fires like a big barrage. I thought that would have worked, but I guess not. Still think we're gonna succeed here. The great thing about this is that, like, the fire is like right, or Isaac is like right at the end of the range of the fire, so I think it hangs out there for another second or two compared to normal. Rage would be really good here too. Well, maybe not in this fight, but on this run it would have been great. Anything to allow us to do even more damage than we already did would have been insane. So We're almost done here. Pretty much just tanking the hits here. Just tanking the hits, tanking the hits. One more. Yes, okay. One more angel fetus and we are done here. Sadly, no Polaroid because I'm an idiot. But in any case, that was a decent run through the Binding of Isaac and lots of fun. We would have stood a chance at the chest for sure. But in any case, thank you guys for watching my post-Isaac stretch. I will see you guys next time.